Your Excellencies, Governors who are present here, led by the Chair of the Council of Governors, Madam Anne Waiguru, CS Aisha Jumwa, Principal Secretary is present here, and women leaders, good morning. Hamjambo. It is a wonderful morning for us, and for me specifically, to be here this morning to participate in this very important event. Our nation's quest for prosperity has been hampered by fundamental inclusivity deficit, which is a consequence of chronic unresolved marginalization on regional, ethnic, socioeconomic, and gender basis. We have resolved as a people to implement a bottom-up economic transformation agenda not only to address these shortcomings, but also to build a nationwide, all-of-society, multidisciplinary, multisectoral, grassroots-to-capital coalition of Kenyans, of Kenya's women and men, both young and old, and of all walks of life, to make up for lost time and to deliver shared prosperity within our generation. And that is why I purposely came for this event, because it speaks to the heart of what we need to do together as a people. Kenya has been making steady progress in many sectors for many decades now. However, the rate of progress has always remained behind the levels of poverty and inequality, making sustainable development and inclusive growth an elusive target for the majority. There are a number of underlying structural causes of this state of affairs. The least appreciated of these structural hindrances is almost the most obvious. As a nation, we do not have all hands on deck, and for six decades have locked a significant part of our population from contributing to and benefiting from economic growth and national development. As a result, the opportunities we have denied ourselves are vast. The cost of this persistent and systemic omission is huge, and the negative impact on the people, especially the most vulnerable, is immense. It is clear that a truly inclusive economy would be at least twice as productive, meaning that we would have exceeded our most ambitious development projections long time ago. We can accelerate our progress to become an industrialized, high-income economy by radically enhancing the inclusion and participation of women in leadership. And speaking about women and participation in our country, even when we speak even about politics alone, despite that we have few women elected,